Hello, and welcome back. I was looking through the reconstruction requirements, and it looks like I can do everything but Special Level 5 at this moment. All the materials that I need can be acquired from enemies that are well within my level range, but specials materials can only be farmed from enemies in the new version of Prison Island. For those, I'll need to progress the story even further, past the Bionis interior and a boss and whatnot, and I don't really want to do that right now. Plus, the final quest in the reconstruction process requires fighting a level 99 pseudo-super boss, and I don't want to separate that from the reconstruction. So, that'll be a while. As always, I have links to my Ko-fi and Redbubble in the description below. If you like what I do and or want my art in your things, you can like, you can comment, you can subscribe. More importantly, we can use our time and money providing aid and support to Palestinians as they suffer under the latest atrocities of an 80-year-long assault on their human rights. And with the Zionist scum expanding their atrocities, the Lebanese are in need of aid as well. Beyond Israel's genocidal onslaught, there are atrocities in Sudan and the Democratic Republic of Congo that could also use our support. I'll put links for those in the description too. And now, it's showtime! Yo, let's keep the Shulk train rolling. I mentioned way back in episode 75 that we've acquired all of the Monado arts that we are required to get. There are two more hidden in the world that are optional, and I decided to save them for late game for some reason. Probably because I wanted to say we've acquired all the Monado arts that we are required to get. Realistically, I probably should have grabbed these two before losing the actual Monado, since the replicas don't have the ability to display the symbols, but we're here now. In hell. We'll ping back to Frontier Village first and talk with Lupa at the Archaeology Center to get this ball rolling with kind Lupa's Grampy Pawn. And its subquest, Secret Elixir Ingredients. Where am I? That's a much. I could not handle living here. I could not. Ah. Even that gives me the heebie-jeebies. Lupa! Lupa!
Me? Me? Friends, did you see my Grampy Pawn anywhere?
Tell me in greater detail. I think I know what's going on. It's, you know, that, please stop embarrassing us.
He should be in Colony 6, but there has been no contact from him since the Metcon attack.
In Colony 6? Where are you looking?
Oh no! Please don't tell me you all killed.
How did you get that from that?
A few managed to escape, but it would be difficult for any of those to contact this village. Actually, I want friends to take him some secret Nopon elixir. First, I need help making it. Do friends mind helping me?
Kind Lupa's Grampy Pawn.
My Grampy Pawn taught me much over the years. I wonder how he's doing in Gonging 6. I want to give him some secret Nopon elixir. Friends would do it? Thank you.
Rest assured that your issue will be attended to with haste.
No. You're way too stiff. Try this. Gotcha. Leave it to us.
I am unfamiliar with such coarse phrasing, but I shall try.
Gotcha, friendio. Leave it to us, mate.
Is that correct, Sharla?
First, I need three things. Hades beetles, all-seeing eyes, and potent Brog poison.
Secret elixir ingredients. That came out weird. Drinking the secret Nopon elixir in the bath will make you live long... In the bath? Okay.
That's what Grampy Pawn says. Collect what I need for elixir.
We need to grab 5 Hades beetles in Machna Forest. That's collectible. We already have enough. Good. We need to grab 3 all-seeing eyes from Jungle Quad Wings in Machna Forest, which we have enough of, conveniently. And we need to grab 2 lots of potent Brog poison from Poison Brogs in Satural Marsh. We only have 1 of 2, though. Let's rock! Beyond farming for the Hades beetles, we could come out here to the right somewhere. Are you a Baba? Are you? Is you the Ababa?
you are. Ababa offers them for trade at One Star Affinity with the Frontier Village area.
Nipa
also offers the Hades Beetle for trade, starting at 3-star area fitting. Let's see, where is Gadada? You're just a rando. I can't see with your special quest over your head. Oh, there you are. So Gadada has another follow-up quest for us after his whole ordeal with the city trade. But he also offers the Hades Beetle as his overtrade item for 7,200 G. I believe the jungle quad wings are able to drop the all-seeing eyes. Let's kill this freak. Let's kill him real good. Just obliterate his entire face. There's one. But they can also be traded for. One option is here. Norara offers them at 2-star area affinity, only before immigrating to Colony 6. And what is this hitbox? And Atael. He offers them as his overtrade item for 1,800 G now that he's here in Frontier Village. After Makana's core. You look ridiculous. I believe poison brogs can be found here in the poison swamp and here in the dark swamp. Jump. Here we go. Poison brog. Yeah. Oh, that's less damage than I was expecting. Still annoying, though.
This represents no problem whatsoever. Okay, let's sort this out nice and quickly. This should be easy. One, two, only now have you realized our true power. Let's stay alert. Let's press on and on and on.
There we go. Yeah. You collected all Nopon secret elixir materials. I need you to bring them to me. Good. I'm glad. There is one trading option for potent brog poison. It's a Gawago. Except he only offers it after immigrating to Colony 6. And only when you reach 5-star affinity with the area. Otherwise, he's still here. Doing this. By Ricky's house. For some reason. As a invitee, he and another Nopon, Minana, are mutually exclusive. They each require housing level 5 and Berry Jammy to have already been invited. Interestingly, the Definitive Edition changes his trade pool. In the original version, he would offer poisonous gourds at 3-star affinity when in Colony 6, but the Definitive Edition changes that to the Venom Platypus. I am back, Lupa. I am back with your strange objects.
Me? Hades beetles, all-seeing eyes, and some potent brog poison. All here. Fantastic. Do friends mind waiting a little while? I managed to make Grampypon's secret Nopon elixir. Grampypon drink it every day. He said for his health, not because he's a functioning alcoholic. I want friends to take some of this elixir to Grampypon.
Secret Nopon Elixir. Healthy tonic made with ingredients from Machina Forest. Excellent. Cool. I believe that's Sitata right there. Once he's back in Colony 6, after you get all the refugees back, he'll be found right here. We've dealt with him before.
If you start this quest before you get the refugees back to Colony 6, he can be found in the refugee camp on the Brass Lake, of course.
Hello?
So Tata knew that smell?
My nose has been bothering me. Anyways.
Friends carry secret nope on elixir. Friends got that back at Frontier Village. Am I wrong?
Well then.
She remembers everything Zatata taught her about her secret elixir. Tell her not to worry about me. She is capable of finding out secrets of Machna without me.
Cool. Thank you. So annoying. I have to keep changing time. And she is not in a convenient place. You have to travel a fair distance before you can talk to her. There needed to be more landmarks. In this stupid village. At least one here. At least put one on each floor. Please.
Me? You met my grandpapon? That's fantastic! I'm so happy to hear he well.
I hope I was of some help.
Yeah, Millie was big help. Baby Pod Zatata spoke about secrets of Machna. I will find out the truth behind these secrets. I'm glad that Grampy Pond Zatata is well. I will carry on his work and discover the secret of Machna.
You know, I had briefly forgotten what I was doing in this episode. Anyways, now Lupa offers a series of side quests involving the mystery of Machna ruins. There's four of them, and the fourth one provides the thing that we're looking for. Anyways.
There's some really ancient ruins in Machna. I want to do some research there, but the door will not open.
A problem.
That's a big, big problem. I was hoping you would say that.
I mean, I didn't really say anything that would prompt that response.
Have friends ever been to ruins? That way I want to do some surveying. Licky did see really old house out there. What's Lupa going to do in old haunted house? Frighten ghosts to death? Didn't I just say I want to do a survey there? No one have yet to learn about those ruins and... Stop! Lupa talk too much! Time to decide! I need to see the ancient documents to open the door to the ruins in Machna! Search high and low in Machna for them!
Grab 3 ancient documents from various locations in Machna Forest.
I need 3 ancient documents in order to open door. All likely somewhere in Machna Forest. Do your best to find them, friends!
Rest assured that your issue will be attended to with haste.
Oh, my voice is not going to like me after this.
Two of Bionis' bravest and boldest women at your service. Fiora is certainly high-spirited today. It appears I shall have to double my efforts.
We'll just jump to a random spot in Machna Forest. Still a heat wave, still Bagrus Nebula here, and they will kill us so fast. So very, very fast. Just picking a random spot to pop in will allow us to figure out where all of these things are. Okay. Odd landing site, there. Is that on the cliffside or on the riverside? Might as well get that one first. Where am I? Which direction am I facing? We will never be forgiven for our sins. Honestly, you guys are insane. I never realized that you had 2 faces. What is that, like a baby? Why does your face get so much smaller when you become big size? Anyways, enough of that. I will say, I do appreciate how Xenoblade 3 does outfits. Mostly because, I mean, look at this. Look at it. It is insane. Oh, God. That guy's having a bad day. I need to be down there. I might as well go back to the bridge. Jump off from here so I'm not risking landing on the shore. Xenoblade 3 and Xenoblade X have pretty good outfit selections. And I appreciate that. Instead of these truly insane outfits that these poor bastards have to deal with. Ancient documents! And last one. It's up there. I just can't help myself. I always go for the little collectible nodes. I love collecting things, which is why I like gacha games and all that sort of thing. It's bad for me. It's bad. I have a great desire to collect everything. This outfit is especially ridiculous, though. Where did your wings go? Have you managed to stuff them into the little ears on your helmet? Where's Lupa? Coward! Get back here.
Finn's got the ancient documents? Show me! The key to deciphering this lie in another document. My neck hurt.
Ow!
I should be able to read this. I can decipher it right away. Come back to me shortly.
And kicks us out of Mystery of Magna Ruins 1.
You found the ancient documents. It'll take me a little while to translate.
Outdated junk, and immediately into Mystery of Magna Ruins 2.
I know how to open the door of the Magna Ruins.
I'm trying to speak too quickly. I'm just stumbling over my own tongue.
Tell me in greater detail. If merely asking, then Ricky also want to know. Yes, continue. Ricky and I will listen to what you have to say. Ancient documents say to recite the prayer in front of the ruins. Wow, Lupa able to read such tattered book. Well done. Ricky not able to read any of those curly squiggles. These not curly squiggles. This imported ancient writing. Friends not moved by the fact that writing existed in ancient times? Do friends want to try to delve deeper into mystery of the ruins? We must recite a prayer to open doors to ruins. They're big tablet in front of door. Pray real hard at it. Find out what's inside it. Come back and tell me.
Recite the prayer in front of King Agni's tomb. Mystery of Magna Ruins 2.
I knew you would all get excited at the mention of a mystery. Do friends know the location of the ruins in Magna? There are a tablet at the entrance to the ruins. Recite the prayer there. When the door opens, go inside and look around for me. Rest assured that your issue will be attended to with haste.
I can't believe I'm going to have to come back to you again. And this one again. We've already been to King Agni's tomb. So that's easy enough. Oh. That's upsetting. I do not like that noise. What is this? Oh, Ignaz. Why are they dead? Ants and bats and all manners of terrible, terrible things. Hey, a Hades beetle. Where is your hitbox compared to your model? We have to kill you. Let's kill him. It'll be easy. And welcome back to the music that gets the video claimed. Let's skip past this. This isn't exactly a important fight. Or hard for that matter. Good. He's dead.
doesn't look like I can open the giant coffin. I can feel a draft coming from a gap below the coffin. We should go back and tell Lupa.
Why are all his friends dead already? How is he in here?
Lupa, I'm back. Why do I have to keep coming back to you? So, friends found a huge coffin inside the ruins. They're called King Agni's Tomb. Where you would expect to find a coffin. This indication that these ruins are the ancient giants. Friends felt a breeze blow from underneath the coffin. So, something may lie beyond the coffin. Right, I would have to come up with a way of finding out. Now we have evidence that ancient giants lived in Machna. This wonderful! The coffin deep inside the ruins. We must move that coffin! We must desecrate the dead.
Outdated junk. Mystery of Machna Ruins 3.
Right! I have come up with a way to solve the next mystery. Tell me in greater detail. You fine warriors should have no problem moving the coffin. Coffin? With dead thing in it? Lupa want us to move it? What if skeleton monster jump out at Ricky? Yes. If friends find bones, then bring them here to me. It may help us understand the biology of the giants. Bones? Lupa want us to bring bones? We need lubricant oil to move the heavy coffin. Go get materials.
Grab 3 lots of aqueous Andos oil from Flavel Andos at Aerith Sea, and grab 3 lots of Algora sap from Sap Cave in Machna Forest. I think I've been there before.
I need some Algora sap and aqueous Andos oil. Friends can get these in Machna and Aerith Sea. I will then blend them together. Rest assured that your issue will be attended to with haste.
What, no comments from either of you two jokers? Huh?
Don't you run from me.
We had a number of trade options for the aqueous Andos oil. Unfortunately, we only have one at the moment. An option we no longer have is Galdo, who is dead. He was one of the guards at the staircases in the Great Hall in Alchemoth between 18 and 6. He would have offered the oil at 3-star area affinity with Aerith. But he is dead. He is dead now, so we can't do that. Another option that we would have is Teelin. Now that we have finished Mikar's core, he'll have moved to the ether plant in Aerith, and we can find him between 6 and 18 during the day. He's not there at the moment. He's currently trapped in Alchemoth, so until we rescue him, we cannot trade with him for this item. We do have one option to trade for the aqueous Andos oil with, and that is here at the ether plant, Drak. Drak offers them for trade starting at 5-star area affinity, which I have reached. Sure, take this. I don't care. I see. Wow, this is fantastic. Here, have this too. Murky Elika water. Great. Thank you. See you next time, yeah? If you want to If you want to farm for them, I don't recommend it. If you want to farm for the oil, the Andoses that you're looking for are in this area, are just around. But as you can imagine, this might be not a great idea. What with the Telethia here. Going for it.
Stronger.
Ricky, like fighting easy, monster.
monsters.
There we go. Jumping to the Nopon Arch, the Algora Sap is a unique collectible that we've technically seen before a long, long time ago while I was wandering aimlessly, while I was trying to fill out the Machinum Forest map. Because one of the areas that I needed to fill out the map is behind this big old frog and is where we can find the three lots of Algora Sap. Here we go. Sap, 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 sap. Sap, 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 sap. What, it doesn't slow me down? Come on, it's sap. That should definitely slow you down. Let me look at the sap. A highly sticky resin that's shiny and gloopy. Gloopy? Oh, time bomb. Why do I have a time bomb? If it used to destroy... Why would I still have it then? It's a bomb!
Me?
Now I have all the materials to make lubricant oil!
With sap? But why? How would that make lubricant?
We must mix the Algora sap and aqueous Andos oil thoroughly. That will give us a smooth lubricant oil.
I don't understand your reasoning.
If friends use this on the coffin, they should move easily. I look forward to hearing what lies beyond the coffin. I can make excellent lubricant oil now. You can rub this on the coffin to move it.
Lubricant oil allows you to move even the heaviest object. I don't think that's how that works. Oh well. Ah. And immediately, Mastery of Magna Runes 4!
Now it's time to move the coffin! Thank you for helping me! Finally, challenge for friends! Find out what's inside the tomb! Good luck!
Well, I need to open it again? Oh no? Is it just open now? Oh good. Look at all these dead lizards. These poor bastards.
Did you get eaten up by these ants? And also those bats?
And did your boss not do anything to help you? Yeah, that's how that works. Cool.
Bunch of collectibles. How fun. There's only a treasure chest in the center of a small room. Let's go and tell Lupa.
But first, let's steal. Eater records, and also Battle Soul. Allows anyone who studies it to learn the Eater Monado art. So, you know, Shulk. Lupa! We've stolen from you.
So, friends found a small room under the coffin. And a single treasure chest inside. It may have been the custom of the giants to build this secret room. These very intriguing results. I will let friends have the contents of the treasure chest. Lupa has no interest in riches, and friends may find them useful. Please, take this piece of giant's treasure, too. It's an old family heirloom. I finished studying it. Friends might find a use for it. I told Grandpapon I would solve the riddle of King Agni's tomb. Now I have fulfilled that promise.
Excellent.
I'm so happy to have the mystery of the ruins solved. This discovery will go down in history.
For that, we get Barrier Nasher and Heart of the Giants. This isn't the first of the Giants thing that we've gotten. I forgot to look up when I did that quest before. But all of these of the giants things, I think there's three, all of these will be useful for another quest. Anyways, cool. Thank you. Thank you for just having this incredibly rare heirloom. My God, there's a fast travel point right here. I don't need to go down to Ricky's house every time. What am I doing? This would have been so much faster. Slightly, a little bit, kind of. You have learnt a new Monado art from the records. Eater. And we've also increased the level of battle soul that we can get, which is useful. Let's talk about Eater. The Monado's power consumes enemies, including any buffs. It doesn't heal you, though. It just removes buffs. I have not leveled up Cyclone. Yes, Eater. This is an Aether attack that deals damage to enemies in a fan shape ahead of Shulk. Its big use is to strip away enemies' buffs, though it also inflicts bleed for 20 seconds, dealing 20% of the initial attack's damage every 2 seconds. Something to note is that it doesn't remove buffs that are the result of an aura. For those, you'll need to use Purge to get rid of the aura itself. The kanji for Eater is Ku, which literally translates as to eat, specifically prey. It's a pretty powerful art. It's a shame that Shulk's AI typically just uses Buster. It really likes Buster. There's one more. Here on the Fallen Arm, we can finally approach Elika for her quests that I postponed for honestly no reason. Elika! Elika! Oh no, what do I do? Oh no, what to do? Soon the village will be in danger. If no one puts a stop to this, we'll all be in big trouble. Sounds like you've got a problem. You will listen to what I have to say? Oh, thank you. What's happened is, I recently saw some Mechon really close to the village. I'm always going out of the village and collecting scrap nearby. When I was doing that the other day, I saw these huge Mechon walking around. I was so scared. I ran off as fast as my legs could carry me. Just think what would happen if those Mechon got into our village. Now I'm even more scared. Please help me. Help us all. Protect our village from the Mechon.
I hadn't expected you would be in such dire straits. Naturally, we would be delighted to assist you. We couldn't simply ignore a matter like this.
You really don't mind? Praise be to Maineth. She's always watching over us.
Well, she's not watching over you anymore.
When Elika was looking around the village for parts, she saw some large Mechon. Defeat the large Mechon so they don't pose a danger to the village. Defeat 3 M85 Meteor Artillery units on the Fallen Arm. I forget, for that, we get Strength down 5 and Weapon Power 4.
Thank you. I saw the Mechon just past the back path behind the village. You can get to the back path via the pipe surrounding the village. It's opposite Junks. I'll open the door that leads to the back path for you. I'll also pray to Maeth to keep you safe. That way, you can keep everyone else safe.
Safe. Yes, great. Cool. Awesome. No problem. Leave it to me.
Hereupon, show you what he can do!
There's a back path? Where? You say along the pipe? Well, is that tiny hole right there? You know, I've never known about this hole. Oh yeah, there's a path right there on the map, isn't there? Fascinating. You know, that would probably have been easier to know. Easier, better known beforehand. Yes, great. I am breaking. My mind is breaking. Oh, it's these suckers. Okay.
The enemy's weak. But don't drop your guard!
Riki can win by himself.
I don't have time for small fry.
Everybody,
we can definitely do this.
I want to use Eater. Nice. Have I used Cyclone before? Whee! Oh, hello. Oh, you're all friends, huh? I'm gonna kill him. It will honestly be faster to just go to the giant Mechon debris instead of to Junks.
Welcome.
You're all such strong fighters. And because of that, you've made our home safe again. I want to thank you on behalf of the whole village. I'm sure nothing will go wrong. We're very grateful. I'm glad everything worked out. Now I can go back to salvaging scrap again. Wish me luck.
You defeated the large Mechon before they posed a danger to the villagers. And now a bunch of smaller Mechon are posing a danger to the villagers.
Welcome.
Hi, everyone. I was wondering if you would be willing to help me again. It turns out the Mechon you defeated were emitting a signal. Now that the signal has stopped, other nearby Mechon have gone on a rampage.
That doesn't sound good.
And a big, big problem. Those large Mechon must have been in charge of all the others. With no leader, they've gone completely mad. If they get as far as the village, we're done for. I'm sorry to keep asking you for assistance, but you're the only ones who can help me.
No worry. Riki know how you feel. Friends, we must help this person!
Thank you, brave fighters. But you do realize the enemy is a whole horde of Mechon. Are you still prepared to accept the mission?
Because the large Mechon were defeated, the other Mechon have gone on a rampage. Great. They could cause some real damage. Call their numbers. And for that, we get the armor records. Defeat 10 M56 prototypes on the fallen arm. That's just excessive.
In all truth, we should be defending ourselves. Sadly, the Machina have grown weak since we left the capital.
No problem. Leave it to me.
Hereupon, show you what he can do!
I'm standing on my ankle again. Like a freak. 100%? Sure. Let's try to kill them in one shot. With backslash. So I don't have to deal with them. Yeah, you're real on a rampage, aren't you, buddy? Damn.
Let's go through that pretty good. Backslash! Alright. Time for a chain attack. Keep it up, Riki. Good job, everyone. Backslash! Now's perfect for a chain attack.
Riki getting serious time. Not bad. Not bad.
Oh, are we done? Good. I'm glad.
Welcome.
This is the second time you've saved the village for me. I'll never forget that. Now the village truly is safe. I'm incredibly grateful. Thank you.
I'm glad everything worked out.
As thanks for everything you've done for me, please, take this. It's a collection of research notes left by my father. It looks like it's something to do with the Monado. Since the Monado is so important to you, I'm sure it will be useful.
Glorious. You reduced the numbers of Mechon, and the villagers are safer now. armor records. Allows anyone who studies it to learn their armor Minato art. You have learnt a new and final Minato art from the records, armor. The Minato's protection reduces physical and ether damage. Let's talk about Minato armor. Armor is a buff for the entire party that reduces damage taken. It doesn't block status effects or talent arts, and it only lasts for 15 seconds, but at max level, this sucker nerfs incoming damage by a massive 75%. It is powerful. If you build Shulk with haste gems and focus on auto attacks, you can have this thing up almost all the time if you want. The kanji used for armor is yoroi, which translates directly to armor. Interestingly, armor is the only Minato art with two kanji associated with it. That large kanji is used as its symbol in the art selection bar, as well as on the Minato itself whenever it is used. In subsequent games. In Xenoblade Chronicles, however, the kanji that appears on the Minato is different. For some reason. I don't know what that is. Of the many Minato arts that appear in the Xenoblade series, armor is, for some reason, one of the two that appear in all three numbered games, with the other being Buster. Which is also strange, because Buster's entire thing is that it's more powerful against Mechon specifically. If we had done this quest before fixing a broken door, talking to Elika between 9 and 12 would have increased her and Rizaka's affinity to close sisters, a Green Link. However, fixing a broken door increases their affinity to perfect sisters, a Blue Link, and it won't go back down to close sisters, so we missed out on that little nugget. It doesn't really matter, but it's something that was there.
My sister Rizaka and I have always lived together. I collect junk, and my sister recycles it.
That'll probably be it, huh?
I like taking walks outside, and my sister likes fixing things. It's great that we can combine the two.
There is one more quest that Elika provides for us. If we speak with eyes now...
Hi there.
I'm worried about Erica. No point scavenging for a living. Better just to bury stuff. I wish I could bury myself. That'd be the best thing.
Cool, guy! These burials are fun! Come on, everyone, get to it!
How can we make up for all the lives lost? We can't make up for them. I might as well just break down.
You're having a bad time. Now that we've done that, we can get Elika's final quest. Elika's extremely easy, talking-only final quest.
Welcome.
Excuse me, have you seen Eyes lately? He's been acting strangely. Could you go into more detail? But Ricky thought Shulk knew everything about everything!
Not this time, Ricky. We'll just have to listen.
I really need to talk to someone about this. He's been saying and doing some unusual things lately. Shouting things at random or suddenly breaking out into dance. He never used to act this way. It would have been unthinkable. If you see him, would you mind talking to him for me? I'd like to hear the thoughts of someone from outside the village.
Sudden shout and dance? Not strange at all! Ricky wants to shout and dance with new friend Eyes!
You're an odd one. Perhaps if you talk to him, it will trigger some kind of change in Eyes. Please talk to him if you get the chance.
Stress has caused Eyes to start acting strangely. Everyone is worried about him. Talk to Eyes and see if there is a way to help him.
Thank you very much. Hopefully, you can help Eyes snap out of this.
No problem. Leave it to me. Eyes, you weird freak.
Hi there.
Huh? What's up? Wanna help me dig a hole? Gotta dig a massive hole to bury all the bad things.
Burials!
Can't beat a good burial.
bury all of the bad things. Bury to forget, forget and never remember. That's the way to do it.
Hi there.
You asking me why I bury stuff? Because I don't want to think about the bad things, of course. If you're going to get in the way, go and do something else. What are you lot playing at? What are you doing hanging around here and annoying me? What? Ethica sent you? She can mind her own business. Stop interfering with me. Have another chat with eyes.
Hi there.
You're persistent. I'll give you that much. Ain't no one ever harassed me as long as you lot. Don't worry, I'm all right now. Made me feel better to get all that off my chest. I feel responsible for all the stuff that Eggle did. How can I be forgiven for all the lives lost? I can't be forgiven. There's only one thing for it. Dig and bury. And have yet another chat with eyes.
Hi there.
You again. What are you hounding me for? Oh, yeah. Ellica put you up to it. Yeah, I understand. I've started to calm down a bit. All right. I understand. If you say that and you're from Bionis, I ain't gonna... What did I say? It should have been a text box for us. I ain't gonna doubt you. I'll stop trying to forget all the bad things and focus on the future. Yeah. You're right, of course. I can't promise I'll change straight away, but I'll see what I can do. Cool. I fixed him.
Ah, I see. It did seem as though there was something on his mind. The pain of what Eggle has done must have affected him terribly. But I don't have to worry anymore. Eyes is back to his old self. I'm glad everything worked out.
Excellent job, Shulk. You're really growing up fast.
Really? That means a lot coming from you. I won't let you down. You've been an amazing help. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Huzzah! Eyes has cheered up because you listened to his woes. Cool.
I can feel the power.
Ah! Thank you, Shulk. Mutual worry. That's good, I guess. Are you still talking about burials? I mean, you're still kind of pacing around in one spot. At least you're not shouting about it anymore. Yeah. Looks like Raxit's body's been strengthened. So you helped him? I just know he's gonna save a lot more lives. We really need him. I'm thinking of turning over a new leaf. I want to make myself useful. I'm not thinking about endings anymore. All beginnings from now on. That's good. Oh, neat. I didn't actually realize that would happen. I keep thinking about what I can do for the village, but it's difficult. Don't worry about me, though. This time, I ain't gonna overthink things and go all strange. That's good. Good to not go all strange. That'll be it for this episode. I believe there's only one quest left on the Fallen Arm, which also happens to reward Dunban's fifth skill tree branch. Maybe I'll do that next episode? I don't know. For now, until next time, take care of yourselves. It's going to get bad.